Next up, we've got Gordon Howell from Harlequin in New York. Give him a round.
Okay, let's do this thing. Okay, so I could start with exactly the same performance as yesterday. I'd assume that you're new customers, but you're not. You've been to the establishment before, you've enjoyed this amazing coffee. So the menu is already something you understand and something you can interpret. You want that same amazing experience, this lovely natural coffee from El Salvador, from a farm called Valuja, roasted by Hasbi. And all these things give us that anticipation of something magnificent. But you already know that. You want more information this time about how I brewed this coffee. So I'm going to go into that process. So if we turn the cards over again, all the technical information is still the same. The grind setting that we've taken out, the fines, we've taken out the silver skin. We want a more consistent extraction. The temperature, the water I'm using, they're all still relevant. The big change is actually using a submerged method because that gives me really consistent extraction. So when I played around taking different volumes and measuring the TDS and flavour against different methods, I found that the traditional pour over didn't give me great flavour at any stage in the brew process. The first 40 seconds gave me 81% of its extractables and a combination of good and bad flavour. Astringency was there from the beginning. I developed a method that creates a very slow profile. It starts with a TDS of around 1.9 by design and goes up to 2.16. But I stop the brew process. As soon as astringency comes in, which was about on the 17th sample, in time, at 15 seconds intervals, I understood the coffee better. And as soon as we understand the coffee better, we can brew it better. So whenever I get a new coffee in, irrespective of whether I had that coffee before, the roast will be different. So I need to get the best capacity out of that specific coffee, there and then. So we do a calibration, one by hand, one on a technical board. And we measure what's actually produced in the cup against our calibrating methods to get the very best out of the cup. Then we can change the brew ratios, we can change the line. We understand the coffee better. We have to give it the same respect that the roaster gives. They profile the coffee. The magic doesn't happen by chance. We need to do the same thing when we brew. So today is about that magic. It seems a weird method, but it works. The consistency we get in the cup is there. Flavour is there. It's a science, and we need to respect the science. Time check, please. 2:55. Okay. The other thing I wanted to do, and we'll come into it when we embrace the cup, is introduce a bypass method, which is basically we generate a much more concentrated coffee, and we introduce water. And I wanted to do that specifically to play with the aromatics of the cup. I wanted it to release. So when we stir water into the cup, like a cast strength whiskey, we get aromatics and flavour, and they become more palatable. And for me, the gin drink just became far more enjoyable. So when we look at the cupper's notes, we are aware that we're gonna get strawberries. It is a natural coffee. It is a bourbon. It is high altitude. It is one of the best coffees in the world. It has won the Cup of Excellence. It has won the World Barista Championships. But we can make it taste better by design. The grower, the roaster, and the barista working in partnership generates something that's truly excellent. And that's the end now. Just going to wait this to come up to 95 degrees and then I'm going to start brewing. Locks in that process of brewing. I stir very consistently in one direction for a fixed period of time. I don't back flush. With flushing, you cause the blinds to go back on themselves and it releases more flavour, not controlled flavour. We want control and it's all about control. When we control what we're brewing, we can brew better. Right, ready to rock. So 250 ml, and I'm going to look to produce a beverage of around 160 grams. Each one of these processes takes about 15 seconds, and we're looking to bloom the coffee to release the CO2 for about 35 seconds. This specific brew method will also generate a little bit more acidity than we would expect from a natural, and that's specifically the way I'm brewing it. I want a little bit more pink grapefruit and pink lemonade in combination with all those lovely red fruits, from strawberry to red currants to raspberries, both in taste and texture. The turbulence comes in here, consistently one direction. 10 seconds. I need to be quick, pour all the liquid in and start the extraction straight away. This becomes a self-regulating brew method. The heavy coarse grinds are stuck in there, as you can see, there's a few in there. And they also stick around the filter. The smaller fines stick early, so they get out to the brew cycle when they've done their job. And it all helps with generating consistency in the cup and maximum flavour. So this brew started on 6 minutes 16, 2 minutes thereabouts, to produce that 160 grams, it's very consistent. Thank you. So my aim as a barista, my aim in making the coffee is very simple. I want to get the best out of the hard work of the grower and the roaster that I've done and maximise a flavour experience for our consumers. Hopefully you've enjoyed the coffee today. Thank you very much again. Bag of coffee today. Take away. Thank you very much.
My name is Will Corby. I am head of coffee for PACTcoffee.com and a judge of the UK Brewers Cup and the UK Barista Championship.
I think he probably stood out most with his care, attention, and real consistency that he put into his brewing. Really nailed down all the drinks, very similar in terms of their extraction. And he really understood the coffee in the top three. Finished with a number of points of each other. And, you know, they all did fantastic as well. Really, really great coffee.
It's a real privilege to be able to just sit here all day and be served some of the best coffee in the world by some of the best baristas in the UK,
and probably some will go on to become the best in the world. So yeah, it's a real privilege. I really enjoyed it.
I'm Denise Hall. I'm a competition coordinator for the UK for my last year. I'm also a WBC Simsbury judge, and I'm here today as organiser and head judge. He was extraordinary. So we have our words on the score sheet, and extraordinary is a word that's not used very often at all, and he was really, really extraordinary. His thought and his research that had gone into his presentation and his brew method, how he acted on that to provide a better brew, the coffee he used, just his customer service skills, just totally engaging performance that culminated in a totally extraordinary coffee. So it was a whole package, and I think it's probably one of the most deserved wins of the year, really.
Gordon Howell from the Attic, Harlequin and Northern Academy of Coffee in York. Apparently I've won the UK Brewers Cup with some phenomenal coffee from Asbing and called Illusion in South Natural Plant. Actually the performance was probably one of the best performances I've done across various competitions, British Championships, Coffee Good Spirits. And it just felt really, really good. Like, really serving coffee in my coffee shop, which is great. Just interacting with consumers. It's nice to do that. I'm excited to represent us, all my family, our businesses, and just as importantly, the UK kind of coffee